Hi, welcome to the 280th episode of The Shtick. To celebrate this occasion, we have with us to open the show the director of the Jewish Film Festival, Aviva Kippen.
G'day, Henry. How are you?
I'm very good. I'm so happy to have you on the show at last.
Well, it's a very exciting time to be presenting on Channel 31 because the festival is just that far away. We're opening in Sydney on the 2nd of November.
Yeah.
And in Melbourne here on the 9th of November, so just after this show goes to air.
Yes, can't wait.
Well, I think we've got a very exciting and significant lineup of movies of a great broad range. And the idea is to appeal to a lot of different kinds of tastes. So we've got quite short movies, we've got Australian Jewish movies, we've got movies from Europe, from America, from South America. And as always, the Jewish Film Festival tries to compress the Jewish experience of the whole world into the best movies of the year and offer them in Melbourne and Sydney, and that's what we're doing.
How many shows are there altogether, films in particular?
I rather ask how many kinds of programming there are, because sometimes we have two movies in an evening.
Yeah.
So there are about 17 different programs altogether, about 62 or 63 program sessions all up between Melbourne and Sydney, and that's a lot of stuff to put together for the Jewish community and the general film community of Australia. Very exciting.
And you chose most of these films?
Choosing, yes, and there are two ways that you choose. One is you actually go out and in a proactive way seek films yourself, and the other is, and this has been fascinating to me, always film festival directors and programmers receive material that other people sends them. It's unsolicited stuff that comes through the mail. But this year what's been fascinating is people in the Australian Jewish community have looked for us to say, my father is a survivor from such and such a town, and this other not-for-profit organisation made a movie about their experience, and we would like to know if you're interested to know about this movie. And that was the case with a fantastic film called The Boys of Terezin, which was brought to me by the son of a survivor of Terezin concentration camp who lives nearby to where we're actually filming today.
Yeah.
And I picked up the telephone at the office. The voice at the other end said, hello, are you interested in Jewish films about someone who lives in Melbourne who survived the Holocaust in Terezin concentration camp? This is the story.
Yeah.
And 3 or 4 days later, I was sitting in Inkerman Street watching this movie in the home of the man who survived. And I was moved absolutely to tears by the uplifting qualities of his story and what an organisation called Music of Remembrance in Seattle, New York. Seattle, you'll have to fix that. Seattle on the West Coast in the United States.
That one.
Did in programming a new oratorio of music about the experience of the children in house number one at Terezin concentration camp. So this was something that just came completely out of the blue, found us, and it's like a nail to a magnet. It was meant to be for us.
It's a gem too.
And it's a marvellous movie.
Fantastic. Looking forward to it. Now, the opening night, you're going to have a special film called Leah and Daria. Tell us a little bit about that.
What an extraordinary film this is. Firstly, there are not too many films about the Jewish experience that come out of Croatia.
No.
So
I've been there.
I was absolutely fascinated, first of all, to know that there was going to be a Jewish movie made into a feature-length show from a true story about a child by the name of Leah Deutsch who grew up in Zagreb in Croatia. Leah Deutsch, a Jewish child, beautiful, charming, vivacious, and a top dancer.
And she was a Shirley Temple of the Eastern Bloc.
She absolutely was. And the trigger to how the producer-director couple, Lydia Evander and Branko Evander, came upon the story was they were sitting having coffee with their mates in the nice public square in the middle of Zagreb some years ago, and their Jewish friend said, but of course you know all about the story of Leah Deutsch. And they said, no, tell us the story of Leah Deutsch. Leah who? And there is archive footage of this child dancing as the lead dancer in a company that was then called the Children's Kingdom. Mm. And the Children's Kingdom, in an age before television and before mass media, this little company of kids would learn song and dance routines, and they would travel by train around the countryside of Croatia and entertain.
Yeah.
And it was not a Jewish institution. It just happened to have a Jewish lead dancer. And, of course, when fascism arrived, goodbye, Leah Deutsch, no more Jewish child on the boards at the front of the house. She was removed from the cast in favour of her best friend and the girl with whom she had danced in duos,
yes,
in the company, a Volksdeutsche child by the name of Daria Gasteiger. And the movie traces the interaction of the two families. What happens? How do the girls manage? What is the consequence?
As a response to what was going on in the background.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think, apart from the fact that it's a feel-good movie, songs, dances, costumes,
beautiful,
drama, outstanding dance performers by these two girls who play the two lead roles.
Yeah.
They are the tap dogs of Zagreb. But apart from this, I think it's a very significant moment in the history of the Holocaust, because I've noticed that there are several outstanding films in our program this year, three in particular, that address the issue of children, their place in the Holocaust, and what happened to them.
Right. Well, I just wanted to touch on what the Jewish Film Festival is about as far as being a cultural experience.
I'm stepping into a role that has the privilege and the responsibility to straddle all the parts of the Jewish community. And that is a fascinating and at the same time challenging task. The film festival has been non-aligned, it's non-political, it's not connected with any particular Jewish organisation, and that's the reason that it has its artistic independence, and I think one of the reasons it's survived so long.
Mm. Well, that's fantastic. I'm really looking forward to coming to the opening night, and we'll be showing a bit of that film that you're talking about, the Leah and Daria. We'll be showing that sometime along the way. And it's been so wonderful to have you here. And I want you back as Aviva Kippen, the other side of you, which there are other hats that you wear.
There are many other shticks to talk about in
lots
the future.
Of shticks. And it's been a real pleasure to have you on.
Yeah, a delight to be here.
Fantastic. We'll see you after the break.
Veliko hrvatsko kazalište postaje Dječje carstvo.
Članak 6. Zakona o rasama primijeni meni i mojim roditeljima koji su me hrvatski i domoljubno odgajali jer su i sami tako osjećali, a ja molim Svevišnjega i slavni naslov da ova moja molba bude uvažena. Ja ću s ponosom i sa svim svojim silama nastaviti da se odužim svojoj domovini Hrvatskoj i stvaratelju njezine nezavisnosti i slobode.
I want some more shtick, but I don't have time to shtick around.